Hello, everybody. Welcome back.
Hello, everyone. Nice to be with you again.
观众朋友，你们好。今天是第十九课的后一讲。这一讲的内容分三部分。第一部分是复习，第二部分我们要学习对话，第三部分呢，我们要做一些练习。Okay, now we'll have some questions and answers on the text. 好，现在我们就来做课文的问答练习。Let's start with the first question. Did Florence Nightingale come from England or Germany? Did Florence Nightingale come from England or Germany?
She came from England. She came from England.
What was her family like? What was her family like?
Her family was rich. Her family was rich.
How did young girls from rich families usually spend their time?How did young girls from rich families usually spend their time?
They usually spent their time going to parties. They usually spent their time going to parties.
What did Nightingale think of those parties? What did Nightingale think of those parties?
She found the parties boring. She found the parties boring.
What did she do when she was 30? What did she do when she was 30?
She went to study in a hospital in Germany. She went to study in a hospital in Germany.
What was she in charge of after she came back from Germany? What was she in charge of after she came back from Germany?
She was in charge of a nursing home for women. She was in charge of a nursing home for women.
Where did she go soon after that?Where did she go soon after that?
She went to the Crimea to take charge of the wounded soldiers. She went to the Crimea to take charge of the wounded soldiers.
What were the conditions like in the Crimean hospitals? What were the conditions like in the Crimean hospitals?
The conditions were terrible. The conditions were terrible.
What was the reason for the high death rate? What was the reason for the high death rate?
It was because of bad drains. It was because of bad drains.
What did Nightingale insist? What did Nightingale insist?
She insisted that the government do something about the bad conditions. She insisted that the government do something about the bad conditions.
What happened after that?What happened after that?
Workmen put in a proper drainage system and supplied pure drinking water. Workmen put in a proper drainage system and supplied pure drinking water.
What did the death rate drop to? What did the death rate drop to?
It dropped to 2%. It dropped to 2%.
How did the English people greet Florence Nightingale? How did the English people greet Florence Nightingale?
They greeted her as a heroine. They greeted her as a heroine.
What kind of movement did she play an important role in? What kind of movement did she play an important role in?
She played an important role in the movement to reform hospitals and nursing in England. She played an important role in the movement to reform hospitals and nursing in England.
复习我们就做到这儿，接下来我们要来学习对话。下面我们来学习对话。首先呢，像往常一样，请大家先听一遍。
After the test.
How did you do in yesterday's test?
Not very well, I'm afraid. I made a mistake in grammar and 2 spelling mistakes. I wasn't careful enough.
We all make mistakes, but we can learn from our mistakes, can't we?
How did you do? Did you get everything right?
I didn't make any mistakes, but my handwriting was poor. My teacher told me to pay more attention to that.
In this dialogue, 2 students are discussing how well they did in their test.
这段对话的情形是两位大学生在谈论考试的情况。下面呢，我来对对话做点语言讲解。对于书上注释及自学辅导部分已有详细解释的语言点，我们不再重复讲解。好，下面请大家看对话中的第一句话。
How did you do in yesterday's test?
你昨天的测验做得怎么样？这句话中的 do 在这里的意思呢，是做考试的意思解释。做不及物动词用。考得好可以说 do well in the test or do well in the examination.我们以前学过一个短语Do a good job. Do a good job. 这个短语呢，在这里也可以用。比如刚才的问句，可以换一个问法。
Did you do a good job in yesterday's test?
回答的时候可以这样说 Yes, I did. Yes, I did. 是的，我考得不错。或者呢，否定回答 No.I'm afraid not. No, I'm afraid not. 这里呢是一个简略式的回答，意思是不，我考得不太好。好，下面我们再来看另外一个句子。
I wasn't careful enough.
这句话的意思是我不够仔细。Enough 在这里是副词，修饰前面的形容词careful. Enough 用作副词的时候，一定要放在它所修饰的形容词或者副词的后面。请大家看一下例句。
The room is big enough for 3 people.
这个房间对于三个人来说够大的了。这里的 enough是修饰前面的形容词 big.
He didn't run fast enough.
他跑得还不够快。Enough 在这里是修饰前面的副词 fast. Enough 还可以用作形容词，用于修饰名词，但是这时候它一定要放在所修饰的名词之前，比如
I haven't enough money to buy a computer.
我没有足够的钱来买电脑。Enough 在这里是形容词，修饰后面的名词 money。对话中接下来的一句话是 We all make mistakes. We all make mistakes. 这句话用的是一般现在时，说明某种事实或者现象。这句话的意思呢是我们谁都免不了犯错误。好，我们再来看看对话中的另外一个句子。
Did you get everything right?
所有的题你都做对了吗？ Everything 在这里是一个不定代词，它所带的事物的具体含义可以通过上下文来了解。注意 get 在句中的用法， get 后面跟名词再跟形容词，表示把什么弄成什么样。我们来看看类似的用法。
Let me get this clear. Let me get this clear.
让我把这件事搞清楚。
Please get the papers ready.
请把文件准备好。在上一课中，我们学过 ask somebody to do something， 意思是要求某人做某事。同时呢，我们也介绍了 tell somebody to do something， tell somebody to do something， 意思是告诉某人去做某事。那么这段对话的最后就有一个句子含有这一句型，我们来看看。
My teacher told me to pay more attention to that.
我的老师告诉我要我多注意书写。这句话中的 that 指代前面说过的 My handwriting was poor， 我的字写得很糟这一情况。 Pay attention to 是一个习用短语，意思是对什么重视，对什么注意。短语中的 to 是一个介词，不能把它看成是动词不定式中的 to。好，我们再来看两个例句。
He didn't pay enough attention to that problem.
他对那个问题不以足够的重视。
Please pay attention to the road signs.
请注意路标。对话的学习就到这儿。下面呢，我们要做一点动词时态方面的练习。下面我们请大家把一段叙述中的动词以适当的时态表示出来。现在我先把这段话从头到尾念一遍，请大家考虑一下用什么样的时态来填空。 Last Sunday, Up very early. After we our breakfast, Jack and I to the summer palace. We there at about 9. The weather lovely. It sunny and warm. There, a great number of people in the park. We, a walk along the lake. Then, to see an exhibition in one of the buildings. We at the flowers and the children play. We a good time. It nearly 3 o'clock when we back to school. Then we a shower and a rest. In the evening we a film about Florence Nightingale. We it very much.
Last Sunday I got up very early. After we had our breakfast, Jack and I went to the summer palace. We got there at about 9. The weather was lovely. It was sunny and warm. There were a great number of people in the park. We took a walk along the lake, then went to see an exhibition in one of the buildings. We looked at the flowers and watched the children play. We had a good time. It was nearly 3 o'clock when we got back to school. Then we took a shower and had a rest. In the evening, we saw a film about Florence Nightingale. We enjoyed it very much. Well, we hope you got the answers to that exercise correct. And don't forget to spend some time learning the past tense of all these new irregular verbs.
这一讲内容到这儿就结束了，请大家在课后花一些时间熟记英语中不规则动词的过去式。 Okay, that's all for today. Until next time, goodbye.
Keep studying. See you soon. Goodbye, everyone.